Welcome to my video series in differential equations, and we'll first talk about the first kind of differential equations that we have to know how to solve, the separable differential equations. And in this video, we'll first talk about the idea, the general strategy, and also show you guys one example of how to solve a differential equation by separating the variables. And you can watch my other videos, I will have more examples, including homework solutions for you guys. All right, this is how we should begin.Notice that we have to isolate the dy dx first, right? And you see, this is just the first derivative. Therefore, this is also considered to be the first order differential equation. Sometimes this can be written as y prime. In that case, just write it down as dy over dx. Maybe we are using t for the independent variable, then dy dt then, things like that.Alright, let me write this down again, dy dx, our goal is to focus on the right-hand side first. This right here is a function in terms of both x and y together. Our first job is to separate the x and the y by factoring. Look at the right-hand side, I want to factor it as a function, and I will just write it down as g of x, it's an expression in terms of just x.And the second part is going to be multiplying with h of y, a function in terms of just y. And this is what we mean by separating the variable. Next, and I will suggest you guys to do it this way. Let's multiply dx on both sides. Whenever we're trying to solve a differential equation, the differential should not be in the denominator. So let's take care of that first. And then we will have dy,equals to g of x times h of y, and then we have the dx right here. And then what you want to do is, you want to have all the y's together on one side, and all the x together on one side. You see, we have h of y right here. That should be together with dy. So let's divide both sides by h of y, so they cancel. Now divide this by h of y as well.And the g of x is together with dx, so that's great. On the left-hand side, let me write it down as 1 over h of y, and then let's put the dy on the side, and this is equal to g of x dx. And you see, this is what we mean by all the y's together and all the x together. And congratulations, to solve this kind of differential equation, all we have to do isis integrate this and integrate that. So we just have to do the integrals twice. Okay? And hopefully this is not bad to integrate. Likewise, this is not bad to integrate as well. And now let's take a look of an example. Let's take a look on how we can solve this differential equation. We have dy dx is equal to x plus x times y squared. As I mentioned earlier, the strategy is have the dy dx on one side, which we do, right?So now let's focus on the right-hand side. Can we factor things out? Yes, we can factor out the x because both terms have the x, right? So let me write this down again. dy dx, this is going to be, let's factor out the x. So we have x in the front and we have 1 plus y squared like this. And now I want to show you guys all the steps. Let's multiply dx on both sides. This way, the dx will cancel and we have this, right? And we have to divide.The 1 plus y squared on both sides, so we can bring this to the other side. So let's do that. Divide this by 1 plus y squared. And right here, let me write it down as 1 over 1 plus y squared. And then you see, this will cancel out. On the left-hand side now, we'll just have 1 over 1 plus y squared, and let's put a dy on the side. And then we will have this equal to x with the dx right here.And this is what I mean by this step, okay? And now, I'm just going to integrate this and integrate that. And once again, I'm going to show you guys all the steps. So let's focus on this part here first. The integral of 1 over 1 plus y squared in the y world is going to be the inverse tangent of y. And technically, when I integrate this, I will have to add a constant.And I will add a constant right here. But let me put this down as plus c1. All right, let's focus on the right-hand side. This is equal to When we integrate x in the x world, we have 1/2 x squared. And this is the integral, we should also add a constant at the end, right? So let me add plus c, but this time it will be c2. But as I said, I'm just showing you guys all the steps. In fact, you can skip this adding c1, adding c2 step, because what you want to do next is minus c1 on both sides, so that they cancel. And you see, you will have the inverse tangent y, and this is equal to 1/2 x squared. And now this is the fun part. Here we have positive c2 and then minus c1. A constant minus another constant is just another constant. So I can label this as just c3. So I can write this down as plus c3. And c3 is going to be c2 minus c1, okay? But as I said, later on you can just go from here to here and then begin to label your constant right here as c1. But anyways, this is how I want to show you right now. Well, this is not bad to isolate the y, so we will do that. Let's isolate the y. So to do that, we'll have to take the original tangent on both sides so that tangent and the inverse tangent will cancel. I will do that right here as well. We take the original tangent. Be sure you put both the 1/2 x squared and then plus c3 both inside of the parentheses. At the end, you will have y is equal to the original tangent of 1/2 x squared plus c3. And we're pretty much done, right? So let me just put down a c as a legitimate c that we want to use at the end. Sometimes some books, they may use a capital K right here for the final constant, up to that, right? But this right here is it. This is what we mean by a general solution for this differential equation. And this is it. However, I want to show you guys more, because suppose you're given an initial value. Let's say you have this differential equation along with an initial condition. Let's say y of 0, this is equal to negative 1. And you want to solve this initial value problem, and this is how you have to do it. Solve this way, we get a general solution, right? And our goal is to figure out what this c is. We have to use this initial condition, and the way that this is written, it means that when you have this 0 inside, this means x is equal to 0 and y is equal to negative 1. Y is a function of x. That's why this 0 means x is equal to 0 and the output means y is equal to negative 1. Well, what do we do next? Look at the general form. Plugging negative 1 into this y here, and this is equal to tangent of 1/2, and the x is equal to 0, so we're plugging the 0 right here, and we square that, and then we plus c, like this, right? Alright, so this is going to be negative 1 equals to tangent. This is just 0, so we just have a c inside. So, negative 1 is equal to tangent c. Well, tangent of what angle will give you negative 1? We know tangent of negative pi over 4 will give you negative 1, right? Therefore, c is equal to negative pi over 4. So, with this initial condition, you'll be able to find out what c is, which is negative pi over 4 in this situation. At the end, just plug in right here. Finally, you can say y is equal to tangent of 1/2 x squared. C is negative pi over 4, so I just have to plug in right here. So let me say minus pi over 4, like that. So this is how you solve the initial value problem. And once again, I will have more videos for more examples and homework solutions for you guys.